Yeah, it's just basically a big tube of air that rushes down out of the bottom of a thunderstorm, and it can act like a tornado went through. It can do the same kind of damage as some tornadoes. It can even make the sound of a tornado. A lot of people up there were reporting it sounded like a train coming through. You get that often when people are interviewed after a tornado goes by. So yeah, it can do the same kind of damage, but this was not a tornado. It was most likely a microburst. Let's take a look at the anatomy of how one of those things gets going. A thunderstorm is basically like a big engine. It has inflow and outflow. And what happens is during a thunderstorm, at least the bigger ones, dry air gets sucked into the top of a thunderstorm. It cools very rapidly by a process called evaporative cooling. Then it rushes out the base of the thunderstorm. Sometimes those can go up to 100 miles per hour in the stronger thunderstorms. But microbursts are usually very small and contained. They only affect an area maybe up to 1 or 2 miles. So this whole thing was not microburst winds. A lot of it was just basic what we call downdraft winds out of a strong thunderstorm. There were microbursts and there were downdraft winds that caused the damage. And this is the track of the damage. That storm, it was only one storm. Started out in western Maryland, tracked all the way through the Hagerstown area, Frederick County, Carroll County, Baltimore County. Eventually, it dissipated by the time it got over towards Cecil County. But there were some impressive wind gusts with this storm. In Thurmont, the wind gust was recorded 81 miles per hour. There are some unsubstantiated reports of maybe up to 100 in parts of Washington and Frederick counties, but this is the only one that found that was official. 81 mile per hour gust in Thurmont. Hagerstown Airport recorded a 75 mile per hour wind gust. Westminster and Carroll County, 71 miles per hour. In Parkton, where you saw the video, 62 mile per hour wind gust. It was an impressive event, to say the least, on Saturday night.